peace, peace. Peace and blessings, royal family. Peace and blessings to all mankind. Peace and blessings to every man, woman, and child, all walk of life. Yeah, you know who this is. You know what time it is. It's that positive guy back on the slide. No reason to probably ask why. Brother Henry or Hank, soul conscious, number 4,400 to 4,400, back in time with yet another most pristine, fine, and most sincere and definitely genuine new video. Peace and blessings, everyone. I hope all is doing well. If not, I hope you may get better soon. All the best in life. Positivity over negativity. Before I get started, I just wanted to jump on here quick, because I always try to present things as much as possible from intellectual, logical, and perspectives, and I want to, you know, provide some additional empirical evidence, because I don't want people to think that I would ever try to lie or deceive them or mislead them or to bullcrap them. So I try to base everything on what I do on sound, intelligent, logic, reality, as well as concrete statistics and empirical evidence and stuff. So you can go to, if you want to get additional information to that supports what I'm saying, you can find some or most of it at www.cdc.com or cdc.org. You could Google or Bing search it, the Census Bureau. You can Google or Bing search under statistics for fathers by ethnicity. You could double check at www.wikipedia.com, as well as there was a classic book that I read some years ago. I'm going to try to get a copy or take a look at it again at the library when I get a chance, called Men Are From Mars and Women Are From Venus, or vice versa. If you ever get a chance to read or look at that book, you could go over it. It's a pretty decent book, and it helps to broaden your perspectives on the differences of the genders and what causes, you know, the walls or the gaps sometimes, the misunderstandings between the two genders, especially when it comes to relationships and how we view parenthood and stuff like that. And also www.blacklife.com, www.cnn.com. You can look at the specials of what it means to be Latino in America and what it means to be black in America that CNN did. Numerous offer sources. If you're not sure about something, or you have questions, you want information, let me know. You can let me know. Go to the About a Discussion page. But anyway, with that being said, let's move on. I don't want to dilly-dally. First of all, thank you all for your support. Welcome. For those of you that didn't see my previous thank you and all the videos, make sure you look at them, but don't limit yourselves to the most recent videos only. Feel to go back to the archives as much as you like, share, comment, and subscribe. The topic for this video, family, I'm going to be politely and professionally refuting some false lies, stereotypes, and allegations that we commonly hear that are presented to men that are fathers. And even though I'm not technically a father yet, I feel like I'm a father already because I have several nieces and nephews. Pardon me. I've been given the opportunity in the past to watch children, to help out with my nieces and nephews from time to time. I used to actually work or volunteer with children. So even though I'm not a father yet, but I still, from my own study, experience, and research and reading and studying things over the years, I have a fairly decent idea. Even though I don't have the actual experience myself yet as an individual, I have a pretty decent or good idea of what it means to be a father and a parent. And I have the utmost respect, and I salute those of you, both the mothers and the fathers. Don't worry, sisters. In the near future, I'm going to do a video on the sisters and some of the things, the mothers, in another part. But for this one, I want to focus on the fathers first. At first I was thinking about combining the two, but I don't want there to be any confusion. So to keep it simpler, I'm going to do this video for the fathers. But don't worry, sisters, I haven't forgotten about y'all. I'm going to do a video on some of the positive mothers and some of the ups and downs that the mothers have to deal with, the advantages and disadvantages. But I just wanted to send my love and salute all the positive fathers out there. I want you to know that even though most of the time fathers don't get the credit that they deserve, especially not just in America, but around the world. Now, of course, I'm not talking about the negative fathers, the deadbeat fathers, the absent. I'm talking about those of you that are actually present of all cultures and races, particularly my melanated brothers, my black biracial, so-called black or bright, Aboriginal, Mentelec, Latino, biracial, white, Asian, Hispanic, all Marvel brothers out there. I think the last time I checked, most recently, about 39 to 40 something percent of Latino men are consistently, for the most part, involved in their children's lives, whether they're with the mothers or still or not. I think about 47 to 50 something percent, give or take. Well, in America, you know, I'm not talking about worldwide, but in America, of so-called Caucasian or white men are still a part of their children's lives as fathers. And about last time I checked, according to the CDC and all resources, about at least about 59.4 to about close to 60% of so-called black men are involved in their children's lives in some degree, even though they may not necessarily be still with the mother or married or even under the same roof, but they still stay involved. But yet, in spite of the statistics, and of course, I think the last time I checked, at least about 60 to 60 something percent, or I think, well, I know that, you know, Asians, as far as I know, are the ethnicity in the U.S. presently with the best long-term marriage rate of all ethnicities. I think the last time I checked, the only group of men that I know of that have a higher involvement rate than black men, I think, would be Asian men. I think the last time I checked. But that's only because they have more traditional families intact for the most part. No offense, I'm not knocking them. I'm congratulating all fathers, regardless of race, in this video, but particularly my melanated brothers, my black, Latino, biracial, mixed, and Asian brothers, white fathers. I salute all of you, no offense, but the only reason is because of the fact that I happen to come from the so-called black community, and the fact that black and Latino and biracial men, we have it harder in some ways. But nonetheless, I congratulate and tip my hat to all the positive fathers out there who sacrifice day in and day out to try to do the best that they can for their kids and their family. Sometimes even when the mothers don't want them around, they may dislike, hate them, give them a hard time. They may be involved with new relationships, but yet y'all are still hanging in there, and y'all are not allowing the mothers to prevent y'all from having relationships with your children, and I salute y'all for that. But the only reason why I'm mentioning these statistics, because, you know, we often hear stuff like, oh, all of y'all are deadbeat, y'all ain't no good, you so-called black, or some of you melanated or biracial brothers, y'all don't make as much effort as white and other men. And that's not always necessarily true. You have deadbeat fathers in every culture, race, and men. However, statistics show that a fairly decent majority of men of various ethnicities still stay involved in some measure in their kids' lives. Whether you want to believe it or not, the statistics show that. The statistics also will show that of all ethnicities of fathers, that black fathers are among the best and the most consistent. As a matter of fact, the last time I checked, even though the majority of black men are not married and they don't have children, and the majority of them may not be with the mother of the children, but in spite of all the obstacles that black, Latino, and often melanated brothers face, there's still a decent majority. Now, of course, those numbers are not as high as we would like them to be. But still, 59.4% to 60% of black men that still have some type of contact with their children is better than nothing at all. Of course, you know, in the future, I would like to see that become higher. But nonetheless, I give credit to all the brothers out there that do their best to still stay involved in their children's lives, no matter what difficulties they may experience with the former woman or mother or whatever, or the ex-girlfriend, the ex-wife, the ex-whatever. So, you know, I want to salute you brothers for hanging in there. And I also want to salute the exception to the rule, all you positive sisters out there, that in spite of some of your other female women out there that may want to throw hate and shade, that y'all go against your evil sisters out there. Not all your sisters, if it don't apply, let it fly. But the evil women out there that try to lure you to side with them against the men that really do care, that really do love, and that the positive, constructive fathers that want to, that truly support and want to be there for their children. I salute you sisters that support the good fathers too, and I thank you as well. But this is mainly, you know, even though I send love to everybody regardless of gender, this part here is mainly for the brothers. But like I said, sisters, don't worry, I'm going to be making a video for the mothers in the future. So, and I'm not going to wait until Mother's Day, so you don't got to worry about that. Until Mother's Day after, most likely. So you don't have to worry about that. It'll be coming sooner than that. But because we as the men get the most hate, the most shade, the most negativity, the least recognition and appreciation, I just wanted to do a video for the brothers first. No offense to you sisters. But I just want to thank you. You know, continue to fight the good fight. If I have or adopt children someday, I'm going to put in the good fight as well. I don't care if I have to work 100 jobs, if I have to work 80, 100 or more hours a week, if I have to slave, if I have to dog, if I have to do without certain things. I would do the same for my children, whether they be my biological children, my adoptive children, whatever, my grandchildren. So I just want to thank all you brothers that in spite of all the obstacles that society throws at us, incarceration, temptation of gangs, drugs, violence, baby mama drama, all the ups and downs, lack of employment, loss of employment, scarcity of employment, other economic issues, lack of your own personal transportation or not having a car to go out further for work depending on where you live. All of these things are stereotypes against men. Me too, sexual harassment, false accusations, women and men, often men hating on you at work in the workplace or at school, giving you a hard time. But in spite of all this, y'all brothers still hang in there and you do what you got to do for your kids. And it's from one man to another. I just want to say I love and appreciate y'all. Continue the good fight. I'm rooting for you. All of the other positive people and constructive brothers and sisters that are true and sincere like myself are rooting for you. And if you ever need any help or support, like if you want referrals to programs or services or additional things you may need help with to help you with your kids in what state you live, even if I can't help you directly or refer you directly, I'll do whatever I can to research on whatever you need. You could just message me and let me know. But I just want to salute all you brothers. You know, despite all of the false stereotypes and the hate that you hear about, you know, all of you, you know, all of men, a lot of you men ain't no good. Y'all don't love your kids. That's not true. What a lot of sisters don't understand is that in some cases, I'm not saying all, a lot of times it's not that these brothers haven't tried. It's just that sometimes these baby mothers, they do such reckless things. They do so much to drive you crazy. It's like some of them act like they want you to try to hit or abuse them or do something wrong on purpose so they can use that as an excuse to call the cops on you, put you out, take your kids away, run you back and forth to court. I mean, I don't understand some of these females. Some of them are very hypocritical. On the one hand, sometimes you want to unfairly or purposely make up excuses to separate and divorce from these men so you can get a child support check, extra money. But yet, how do you expect these men to keep paying this child support on time for 18 to 20 something years if you want to keep calling cops on brothers all the time constantly and making them unfairly go in and out of jail, but yet you want your money? So make up your mind. Not that, you know, like I said, this is why, like I said, brothers and sisters, all men and women, you should try to be adults and try to work something out among yourselves. Like, based on what the man makes, he could maybe send you a money order. Or even if the brothers or the man that you're with is only working, making minimum wage, like maybe he could send you $40 or $50 every week or two, depending on how often he gets paid or if he gets paid a salary monthly. But whenever you can, even if the two of you don't get along well enough to mediate among yourselves, if that don't work, you could Google a Bing search. There are plenty of supports and offer social services in every state. You have organizations like, for example, like Catholic Charities, organizations that even though they may not necessarily be able to help you directly, but they can refer you to agencies that could mediate, that could say, you know, provide support services where the two of y'all could have someone maybe act as a mediator, like a social worker, a counselor there, and y'all could work out something without having to get the local, federal, or the state involved. It's always better if the two of y'all could work out something among yourselves for the betterment of your kids. I mean, why drag in the system if you don't have to? It don't make no sense. I don't know why some of our people are so naive and so overly trusting this system. Listen, let me tell you something. The system does not exist to be your friend. The system is there for various reasons. And what a lot of us don't understand is a lot of the time the system is there to, you know, basically to support the powers that be, and they don't care. They'll lock you up, disrespect you, beat you up sometimes. You know, they'll use you, they'll take advantage of you just to keep up a quota or a stat. A lot of times they come into our communities not to help protect and serve like they should, but to abuse, disrespect, neglect, take advantage of you, and put more money into the pockets of the system, the politicians, the powers that be. So y'all need to cool it with that, you know, calling the police 100 times all over on brothers unnecessarily. You know, learn to work stuff out. Keep involvement with the system to a minimum. Take it from your brother soul conscious. I'm saying this, I wouldn't be saying these things if I didn't care. I'm here to try to help. But anyway, take that mustard seed for what it may. I want to say peace, love, God bless. Whether you're a father or not, most likely you probably, if you're not a father or uncle yet, you most likely probably will be at some point in time in the future someday. So take this message for what it's worth. Like, share, subscribe. Peace and blessings. All the best in life. Positivity over negativity. Remember to think right, love right, reflect right, reality right, live right, do right. Treat your fellow man, woman, and child or baby, do unto others as you have do unto you right. Please don't take this message the wrong way. Like I said, I'm not here to bash or attack anyone personally. I'm just generally speaking. So to uplift, to educate, to share information, to offer solutions and ways on how we can work to improve these things. But like I said, if you need additional help or you want me to email you resources that can help, let me know. I'll be more than happy to look it up. You can remember to like, share, subscribe, click the bell button, go to the About a Discussion page, get all the URLs to subscribe to all three of my main current channels, as well as my 4 emails. I'm always a commenter email away. You can email me privately or semi-privately through the About a Discussion page. My 4 main emails are lowercasehenrythehardworker@gmail.com, lowercasehenry or Hank alphamail 4400@gmail.com, lowercase henry or hank 7700@gmail.com, or lowercase ggnewtime@hotmail.com, or you could voicemail or text me. Keep trying to leave messages 24 hours or by text or voicemail on the Soul Conscious line. The current Soul Conscious line, private and secured, is 1-347-641-7056. Or you can comment in the About a discussion page. If you disagree or you have any further questions, you can feel free to let me know, as long as you do so in a polite, mature, adult, and professional way. I know the majority of you always agree with the majority of what I say, but whether or not, I still love you guys. Thank you all for your support. Again, feel free to browse the archives. Don't limit yourselves to just my new videos. Go through the archives, view some of my classic and previous videos as well. Feel free to send comments, constructive criticism, suggestions, peace and love. I'll catch you guys on the fly in the next one. Enjoy the smooth music as we cruise out, and I hope this message has been an encouragement and inspiration. Thank you to all you fathers out there. I know sometimes you get beat down, you get hated on, but just continue to fight the good fight, my brothers. I know I appreciate you, and I know that your children that love you appreciate you. Please keep in touch. Like, share, subscribe. If you want to sub for sub with me, do the same. Let me know. You know, feel free if you have a program, cause, new station, channel, endeavor, and you need me to spread the word, let me know. Feel free to share this video, Google Plus it. You can add it to your playlist. Please share it with the people that you know and love. Please keep in touch. Stay safe. Be well. I wish you all the best in life, peace, and many blessings. And be careful when you cross the street, everybody. A lot of those vehicles can be pretty fast, I heard, especially the Mercedes. Peace, 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 peace.